Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I am talking all about acne. If you've been following me for a little while now, then you've probably seen my skin change quite a bit. I started getting a lot of adult acne last year. I just broke out all over my face and I was just really struggling with it. Now I feel like my skin is in a much better place. It just looks and feels a lot healthier. It's brighter and more glowing, and it's not perfect, but I really like the direction that it's going. I feel like I finally found a skincare routine that's been helping to treat my acne and also lighten my hyperpigmentation and scars and all of that. So I just wanted to sit down and share with you some of the things that I've learned over the past few months, and hopefully it'll help those of you who are also struggling with adult acne and hyperpigmentation. I have a few key things that I want to share with you guys, so let's just get right to it. I wanted to share a little bit of my skin history so you know what my perspective is and where I'm coming from. So I started getting acne breakouts in middle school. Probably just like everyone else, when you hit puberty, you start getting breakouts, your skin starts changing. My dad just nicked it in the bud for me real quick. He brought me to see a dermatologist, and she was just really helpful. She prescribed me medications with ingredients that weren't always accessible at the drugstore. So throughout my teenage and college years, I would see her pretty consistently, and I just had clear skin throughout those years. Like, I would have very little breakouts. After college, I just didn't see her as regularly. I thought I was done with acne. I didn't really have a skincare routine then, but I did experiment with products from Sephora and Origins. I just tried different things. And back then, my skin type was oily. It was especially oily in the T-zone area. Fast forward to last year, man, I thought I was done with acne, but I was so wrong. Adult acne came, and it came hard. I broke out in the space between my eyebrows. I broke out on the sides of my eyebrows. I especially broke out in the lower half of my face, in the cheek area, along the jawline and the chin. Along with that, my skin type changed drastically. It was like dry combination. I would still get a little bit of grease in my T-zone, not as much as before, but the rest of my face was so freaking dry. You could see so many lines. It felt like a desert. Like, you know those photos of the desert and you see the ground and there's cracks in it? That's what my skin looked and felt like. It was just so uncomfortable and so dry all the time, and it just sucked so much. And I know the severity of acne is subjective. It varies from person to person, but having treated my acne when I was younger, I really just wasn't prepared for this new phase of adult acne. Towards the beginning half of the year, I kind of was in denial of how bad it was. Towards the second half of last year was when I felt like, this is actually really, really bad and I need to fix it. I need to do something about it rather than just pretend that it's a short phase that will go away. I really tried to understand why I was breaking out, and I've looked into what it means when you break out in a certain area, but I won't go into the specifics because my face just broke out everywhere. I think it was due to just moving to LA and being in a new environment. First of all, moving in itself to a new environment and doing something completely different is stressful, and that causes breakouts. The environment in LA is definitely not the best for skin. It's very dry here. It's very polluted here. You can see the smog. And my eating habits were just so bad. I wasn't thinking about what I was eating. I just wanted to make sure that I was fed. There were just so many factors to it. And of course, like adult acne, a lot of people tell me it's all hormonal. And I just realized that's one of the things I didn't even list as part of the causes, because I really refuse to believe that my acne was due to a hormone imbalance. And the reason for that is because I really didn't want to take birth control to balance my hormones to fix my acne. I don't know where I got this stigma from, but I'm just really afraid of taking birth control. I've taken it before and I didn't like it. There's just something about it that worries me, that it might affect my body and my ability to have children in the future. I hear birth control works wonders for treating acne, but just for me personally, it's not something that I really wanted to do. So let's move on to the things that I actually did do to help treat my acne. Number one is the obvious one, and that is to drink water. Hydrate yourself. It is just so freaking obvious. I never drank a lot of water when I was back at home, but being in LA, I really just needed to increase my water consumption because it's so much more dry out here. That's all I gotta say. You just have to drink water. Give your body the water and the liquids that it needs. Number two, I actually have never talked about this, but I changed my diet. I changed my eating habits. Last November, when I really wanted to take my skincare seriously, I actually started eating vegetarian. It's not something that I was comfortable talking about publicly because I wasn't sure how long I could be committed to being a vegetarian. And I knew that I had a lot of learning to do. I had to understand what it meant. I was vegetarian for maybe about a month or two, and then I started adding seafood back into my diet because being full vegetarian was just really difficult for me. So basically I cut out chicken, beef, and pork. And when I went to Asia, I actually did consume a little bit of meat here and there. And since coming back from Asia, it's been a little bit harder to transition back to being a pescatarian. I will still have meat dishes here and there. Now I'm just more aware of my eating habits and just trying to eat healthier. And I will say it made a difference, but not the difference that I wanted. So I noticed that I started getting less acne in this area of my face. I don't even remember the last time I had a breakout here, but it didn't help the rest of my face at all. I was still breaking out in the lower half of my face, like around this area. Maybe I expected results too soon, but I was eating vegetarian, pescatarian for maybe about 4 months. And I didn't see a drastic difference in the number of breakouts I was getting, but I did notice that it helped my complexion. In February, I noticed my skin was just a lot more glowier. Overall, didn't really help with the breakouts so much, but in terms of complexion, like yes, it made such a huge difference. For number three, I just wanted to mention something really quickly. If you have the resources to go to a dermatologist or a facialist, definitely go do that because they have the resources to help you treat your acne or your skin, and they can also help educate you on what's going on with your skin. I went to see a skincare doctor in Korea and I got a facial there as well, and it just really helped me to understand my skin a little bit better. It just feels nice to get a facial sometimes and to have a little bit of that extra help along the way of your skincare journey. The fourth thing I did was repair my skin barrier. I didn't even know what a skin barrier was until just a few months ago. I ended up watching a video from Asia, I will link it down below, where she talks about a damaged skin barrier. And it made me realize that is probably what I did. And I'm just gonna read to you what a skin barrier does because I just can't really formulate my own words to describe it. So your skin barrier is the outermost layer of your skin surface, and it consists of cells and lipids. Also known as the permeability barrier, moisture barrier, or lipid barrier, the skin barrier is responsible for making sure essential water and electrolytes don't evaporate from the skin. It also serves as a protective shield against harmful microorganisms by producing antimicrobial peptides and proteins. On top of that, the skin barrier helps sustain skin's immunity and it regulates inflammation. When the skin barrier is healthy, your complexion appears smooth, clear, even toned, and balanced. On the flip side, if your skin barrier is damaged, then that's when you'll experience redness, irritation, breakouts, rashes, burning sensations, broken capillaries, dryness, tightness, and other symptoms you'd attribute to having sensitive skin. So that just kind of described everything that was going on with my skin because my skin barrier was damaged, probably from sun, over exfoliating, lots of makeup, just not taking care of my skin very well in general. I damaged my skin barrier. When I would try to use products to treat my skin, it just wasn't working as well because my skin barrier wasn't keeping the product where it should be. It just wasn't as effective. Again, I will link Asia's video down below because she describes it pretty well in a way that's easy to understand because I understood it. She talks about how it gets damaged and how you can treat it. I'll give you my Cliff's Note version, and that is I bought products that help repair and restore the skin barrier. One that I really love to use now is this one from Etude House. It is their 2X Barrier Intensive Cream, and Ivan actually introduced this to me. I love this. I really, really recommend this if your skin barrier is damaged. It's very light and it sits very well with my other products. Number five, I changed my makeup habits. I just became more aware and conscious of what I put on my face. I made sure to wash my hands before I touched my face. I try to touch my face a lot less. I still end up touching my face sometimes, but I'm trying to get better at it. And I just swapped out my makeup products. Before, I would just slap on any foundation on my face and it worked, it was fine. But with adult acne, I realized like I need to use products that are better for my skin and I need to know what's in it, if it's harmful for my face. So I swapped out my favorite foundations and started using other products that integrated skincare with it. So in general, just be more educated about what you're putting on your face, the types of ingredients you're using, if it's acne prone, if it's irritating for sensitive skin or whatnot. Especially if your skin barrier is damaged and it's sensitive, you wanna make sure you're not putting more on top of it that's going to hurt it. Number six, be consistent with your skincare routine and be patient. It's going to take some trial and error and time to find the products that work for you, so be patient. And once you do find those products, be consistent with it. Don't slip up. I've tried so many products before I found the ones that really worked for me. And I have them all in this bag right here to share with you guys. So I will talk about the things that didn't work for me. Maybe they will work for you, and maybe these will give you ideas on what to try. So I actually started very low. I started with a very low budget. I got these acne products from Target, and these didn't work for me. This is their 10% benzoyl peroxide and their salicylic acid medication, their moisturizer. So I used that for a few months. It didn't work. Then I moved on to Paula's Choice because I heard great things about Paula's Choice. I used their 5% benzoyl peroxide clearing treatment and their exfoliating solution. Oh, also their cleanser. Didn't work for me. My skin was still so dry and I was breaking out all the time. I moved on to the acne regimen. I think there's a third guy in this set, but I don't know where it is. It helped clear up a little bit of my acne, like I wasn't breaking out as much, but still quite a bit. Overall, I didn't like it because it still made my skin feel really, really dry, and the instructions are you're supposed to slather on this benzoyl peroxide treatment all over your face. A lot of it all over your face, and I didn't like that. And I also do not like their moisturizer. It wasn't very moisturizing at all, no matter how much I put on, and it just felt very thick on my face. It just felt like too much. Now I'm using Curology. I saw Hannah use it and it was working really well for her, and I really do like that it's more of a personalized treatment. So this is not sponsored by them, by the way. So you go on their site and they have like your own personal doctor, dermatologist, who listens to your acne concerns. You post your photos and then they give you your own mixture. So this is a mixture made just for me, and it's been working really great so far. I'm a little worried because I've been using it for about a month and a half, 2 months, and I heard there's a purge period where it just extracts all the oil and dirt from underneath your face and makes you have more breakouts before you have less breakouts. That hasn't happened for me yet, so we'll see. We'll see. I was actually really bad at being consistent with my skincare routine, and I actually hated doing skincare in the morning and at night. It just felt like it took too long, like from brushing my teeth to washing my face to applying all these products on, it would take like maybe 15 to 20 minutes or something like that. And I realized it's just your whole mentality to it. And one product really changed that for me. And I've talked about this before. This is Sulwhasoo's First Care Activating Serum. When I first started using this, I really, really loved it. Like I even mentioned it in a favorites video. Their philosophy is that when you start doing your skincare, you first apply this product on your hands, and it has a very like herbal, like aromatic smell to it. So you apply it on your hands, you rub it between your fingertips, and you take a moment to breathe it in and to appreciate it and to appreciate what you're about to do with your skin. Putting all these products on seems like a chore, but once you realize like what these products do for you and how it's enhancing your skin, you start to appreciate the process more. And it doesn't have to be with a product. You can just light your favorite candle when you're doing your skincare and just set the mood, I guess. Like change your mentality on how you view it. That really helped motivate me every day to do my skincare. I knew that once I put this on, I would love doing the other steps. And by the end of it, my skin just feels amazing and it feels moisturized. It just feels great. Sometimes all it takes is a shift in your mentality to help you be consistent and be patient. You just really have to love your skin, and I will get more into that later. But before that, I want to talk about how I actually started lightening my hyperpigmentation. Of course, I still have a lot of hyperpigmentation, but I really like what I'm doing with it now, and I feel very positive and optimistic about where it's going. So to lighten up my hyperpigmentation, I started using chemical peels. You apply it on your face, dry, and you just start working it in, and you'll see your skin start to peel. Like there will be chunks of skin and the product taking away dead skin cells. And I find that chemical exfoliants help with the absorption of my products. It just helps to clean your skin, to lighten and brighten your skin. I also use vitamin C to help clear up my hyperpigmentation. Vitamin C really helps with that, along with just overall brightening of your skin. Moving on to my last point, I feel like it's a fluff point, but I think it's also really important, and that is to really love your skin and just be positive about the whole process. Having acne sucks for sure, but the more you let it bring you down, I think the more you'll stress about it, and stress causes acne. So just be positive about the process. There are definitely moments where I felt so defeated and I was like, there's nothing I can do about my skin, and I just don't know what to do. I found that being proactive about trying to solve the problem helped me to be more positive about it because I was doing something rather than just sitting around and sulking and being sad. So be proactive and educate yourself on what types of ingredients are out there, what's going on with your skin, all of that. Be gentle and be nice to your skin. Like, that was a lesson I found really difficult to learn because I hated it. I hated it. Like, it's so easy. It's so freaking easy to say, like, I love my skin now when it's in a better state. Like, for sure, it's much easier to say now than it was to say, like, 6 months ago. But it is really important to know that, like, when you're putting products on your skin and on your face, like, you have to really be gentle and be nice to it and just really love your skin and be positive about it. And the way I see it is your skin is trying to tell you something about you. Something is off with what you're doing and it's communicating to you that you need to fix it and you need to change it, whatever it is. For me, it was my stress, it was my eating habits, it was just not drinking enough water, all of those things. Like, my skin was screaming out for help and I finally had to listen. So that's kind of what I wanted to share with you. I know it's not an easy, quick, simple solution or anything like that. It's not a shortcut answer. It's quite the opposite, but it has been so worth it to nail it down and to finally feel like my skin is in a good place. And I hope that this video was helpful for some of you. If you have any tips or advice, or if I got any of my facts wrong, anything you'd like to add, please leave a comment down below. And I plan on doing a more in-depth skincare routine, so look out for that. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!